Well, Nola, the Crescent City, the Big Easy. A lot of names for that city down in my Mississippi Delta. But we have a really great show for you. It's a lot of fun for us to put together. Hang on one sec. Is that better? Okay, good. I'm checking the sound guys like that's good. But yeah, the Big Easy got a little thing, our neighbors just down south in New Orleans. So, you know, enough speechifying, let's get them crawdads to boiling. And let's get this party started, shall we? You know, those of you that know me know I'm a bit of a mover. I think I'm gonna lose this. I'm worried you're gonna lose an eye. But you know, I'm all decked out in my beads, and I didn't even have to do anything unseemly to earn them. I beg your pardon. But you know, the whole region of the Mississippi Delta, well, the music that comes from there, very famous bit of music called Zydeco. You know, and it's a blend of blues, rock and roll, jazz, and swamp pop, Cajun music, Creole, traditional Creole music. It's all mixed together in kind of a musical gumbo. Yeah. You see what I did there? Right. But it has a distinct sound to it that's really a lot of fun. So without any further ado, let me give you a couple of numbers of Zydeco. Thank you. He wrote the Grand Canyon Suite. It's one of his more famous works. But he also wrote a beautiful work called the Mississippi Suite. And that kind of gives you a little travelogue into the Mississippi Delta and that whole region there. And it really is a mixture of a whole lot of different cultures. Of course, Louisiana their first immigrants were the French. And the French, well, they kind of mingled with the Native Americans. And that culture sort of absorbed into that, as did the African-American slave culture. And it just all sort of melded into the Cajun culture, with the music, with the language. There's the French Creole, there's the Haitian Creole. It really is quite a melting pot, you know, when America was young. Right there in the hotbed of the Crescent Valley, right there at the in a place that is pretty doggone humid. Well, when you look at it, the first number that we're going to do is called the last two movements of the Mississippi Suite. There's Creole Days, and it kind of gives an atmosphere of, you know how it is when it's just too hot and humid to do anything except sit on the porch and have a cold one on the bayou, watch the gators go by. And then, of course, the fourth movement, Mardi Gras, because after all, down in the Crescent Valley, it's always time to party.
Thank you.
I'm gonna step off the stage and mop my brow. I want to introduce to you the Atlanta Pops Brass Quintet. St. James Infirmary Blues. Now, there's a quote I heard from a movie a long time ago. The blues ain't nothing but somebody good feeling mighty bad. But speaking of someone that's just really bad, and by bad I mean good, this is going to be featuring a gentleman back here on the tickling the ivories. You know him?
Yeah.
Julio Barreto. So let's see what he's got.
Thank you.
next number, it's our, this is one we're going to play before you take a little break and grab a little something, a little drink out in the lobby. But this is one we play a lot. It's kind of turned into something of a signature piece, but of course one of the true ambassadors and godfathers of jazz is Louis Armstrong.
Yeah.
Right? And so many songs that have made their way into the musical songbook, the American, great American songbook. And so this is our little tribute to New Orleans' favorite son, Satchmo.